probably downstairs.
Yeah, just getting them lined up.
Slashing
the whole time? No, I'm actually gonna turn it off right at 6 o'clock. That'll find a nice little up there.
Good evening. Welcome to the 138th commencement exercises for Collinwood High School. The class of 2021 is pleased you could join them in this momentous occasion. Please take your seats as we prepare to honor our graduates. Before we begin, please take out your cell phones and put them on vibrate or turn them off. Please keep the aisles clear so that everyone can see the graduates and the program.
Thank you. Please rise.
Y'all ready? Come on.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which we stand, one nation, under God, individually, for liberty and justice for all. You may now be seated. What am I doing? I will now welcome to the stand, Vellante L. Paul.
Everybody doing? I came today to talk about the senior reflections. So I personally feel like I had a lot of classmates. They was going through a hard time when the corona hit. I saw a lot of people want to drop out. So I just want to thank everybody. I know it's a big time. I see people crying. I'm here with y'all, though. I would like to introduce to the podium Eric Gordon, Mr. CEO at Cleveland Metropolitan School District.
You want to finish those reflections? Finish later? I'm a little shorter. Let me move this down. Good evening, moms and dads, grandpas and grandmas, brothers and sisters, aunts and uncles, friends and family. Welcome to the graduation exercises for the class of 2021 for Collinwood High School. Before I share my brief remarks with the class, this has been a tough year for everyone. But because of the work of the educators at Collinwood High School and the educators in the Cleveland Metropolitan School District, we're here. So if I could ask all of the educators who have worked so hard this year at Collinwood and across the district to please stand and be recognized for your work. I'll keep waiting until you stand up. So if you are an educator in the district, you need to get off your butt and stand up so we can recognize you. So I'm going to try to stand a little sideways. I'll do it this way, because I want to talk to the class. And I'll be brief, but this class, when I came to Cleveland to start working in the district, this class was in preschool. And so this class has grown up, or I've grown up with them, to this stage today to see you as seniors. And so it's especially proud for me to be able to join and be here with you. I want to ask you to do two things, and this is going to be a great camera moment for all of us in the audience, so if you have your phone or your camera, you'll want that out. I'm going to ask all of the graduates to stand up at your seats. And what I want you to do is I'm going to give you two directions, and I want you to do the direction as soon as you hear it. So the first one is to put your left hand as high as you can reach it into the air, your other left hand. Works every time. And okay, so they're as high as they can go. So I'm going to give you a count of three, and this is when you're going to want to take your picture. So on the count of three, I want you to do the next thing you hear. One, two, three, go higher. Yeah, here, see, you saw what happened? They got like a 6 inches taller, right? All right, have a seat. And here's the other thing that I want you to do. It's hard to do with a mask. So I want you to close your eyes. Yeah, if you can see me, your eyes are not closed. Okay, so I want you to listen to the next sound that you hear. So keep your eyes closed and listen to the next sound that you hear. And families and friends, this is the sound that they need to hear. I need you to scream your baby's name because they are on that stage. Make them hear it all the way at Collinwood High School. Is that all you got? That's good for the suburbs. That's not Collinwood. Come on, Collinwood. Make some noise. They're graduating, y'all. Believe it or not, there's a point to this. Let me tell you what it is. See, I know that some of you sitting here doubted that you would make it here. That you didn't think you were going to pass that class or pass that test, or that you couldn't take another day of Zoom, and then you couldn't take hybrid and in-person either, and that this wasn't worth it, and you said to yourself, I'm done, I'm going to quit. I know some of you thought that. I also know that there are people out there, not in here, but out there that have told you you don't belong here because you're black or because you're a woman or because you live in poverty or because you went to a Cleveland public school. I know they've told you that. But what I also know is they are wrong. They're wrong. Those diplomas back there are the same diploma given to every single student in the state of Ohio. Yours is not less. Yours is not less of anything. It is the same ticket that all of those people who told you you shouldn't be here picked up. So as somebody who has watched you grow up from preschool, I wish for you that you would never doubt yourself again. That you would never say, I'm not sure I can make it. That you would never say, I've gone as far as I can go. I wish that I could make sure people don't tell you that you shouldn't be allowed to live here. You shouldn't be allowed to date that person. You shouldn't be allowed to have that job. You shouldn't be allowed to go to this school. But the haters are gonna hate. So, what I can give you is the next time somebody tells you that you are not worthy of the things that you desire, or you start telling yourself you can't do it, I want you to close your eyes. I want you to remember the sound and the feel of this love that just poured over you. You felt it. You didn't just hear it. You felt it. I want you to remember this, and then I want you to stand up, and I want you to go higher. Congratulations to the class of 2021.
All right, good evening. I want to introduce our first student speaker. He is none other than a dedicated young man who once was caught red-handed cheating in my chemistry class. Then he dropped the slip of paper on the floor and kicked it with his foot. But now he is the class of 2021 president, and he is about to get out here and take on this world. I present to you our first student selected speaker, Tabaris T.J. Scott.
Oh yeah, y'all know I was trying to cheat. But I passed. Hey, we passed, y'all. Good evening to everybody here. Parents, students, class of 2021, Mr. Gordon, Mrs. Frew, and all guests of 138 commencement ceremony. I want to start by thanking God for letting me live this long to make it here. I want to thank my mom, wherever she's at, for never giving up on me, for always having my back for everything you truly love. I want to thank every Collinwood teacher up here right now for pushing me, keeping me going. Y'all know I was a pain, so just thank all y'all, man. I thank all y'all. Man, this is hard right here. I think I'm gonna cry a little bit. Collinwood High School has been an amazing experience for me. From freshman year to senior year, despite the COVID-19 pandemic, as a freshman, I watched my sister graduate from Collinwood, and now I am here. And that is one big accomplishment for me and my family. As I stand here today, I know that I am not just speaking for myself. I am speaking for the entire class of 2021. Collinwood has been a crazy ride for all of us, and we will never be forgetting or forget it. And as I exit, I want to remind all of my classmates that each and every one of you did the work to require to get here today. Did the dedication to be, here is one of many milestones to come. Keep grinding, as life will surely be up and down for all of us. Remember, stay positive and keep that happy part of your life with you, and always, always keep going. And now, I will put up our second speaker of the day. Tall, lanky, beautiful, Cheyenne C. Hamilton.
Testing, testing. Okay. It's my honor to deliver the salutatorian speech today to the graduates of Collinwood High School. It is my pleasure to welcome students, families, and staff to graduation. Every one of you has made an impact on the graduates who sit here today. Let me be one of the first ones to say congratulations. We survived. This is the day we have been waiting for our whole lives. I remember the first day of kindergarten, I was a little scared and shy. This is all changed when I started to make friends. Along the way, I made new friends who became family, and they have helped me to get to this point. For those who do not know me, I am Cheyenne Hamilton, the class of 2021 salutatorian. Oh my God. This will probably be the last time we are all together once we walk out the doors of this 138th commencement ceremony. We will be heading down different paths to success. Now I know we will be successful because of all the things we have had to overcome during the pandemic and the pitfalls that came with it. No graduating class has ever been through what we have. COVID hit the country and everything changed. We were sent home like a week or two before spring break. We all thought it was just going to be an extended spring break. Instead, it turned into a long year and a quarter. This year has been hard for all of us because we have had to try and focus on the computer. I know everyone had a hard time getting motivated to drag themselves out of bed, to listen to teachers talk nonstop, constantly repeating to the directions for the late arrivals. I know all the parents here are tired of telling us to get up and get on the computer. In the long run, this will make us better because we have learned how to navigate technology, and it forced us to be more responsible, learning how to use technology. Plus, we no longer had our teacher standing over us to make sure that we did our work. It was all on us. That's it.
The class of 2021 would like to give a token of their appreciation to our CEO, Eric Gordon. All right, coming to the stage.
I'm about to pull this down a little bit because I feel like you can't hear me. Is a gentleman that I've been working with for a couple years now. He never ceases to amaze me on how he is so willing to take your feedback. Sometimes that's criticism. He takes it, he keeps it moving, he takes it and makes himself better. I know great things lie in his future, and I would like to, without further ado, present to you Mr. Brandon Towns, our assistant principal.
Good evening, and congratulations, you guys have made it. I have the distinguished honor of introducing our commencement speaker for the class of 2021, Ms. Jennifer Jordan. Ms. Jordan is a two-time Emmy Award-winning journalist, a two-time National Association of Black Journalists Award winner, and a one-time Radio Television Digital News Foundation Unity Award winner. Ms. Jordan is a graduate of Johnson C. Smith University in Charlotte, North Carolina, where she received her BS in broadcast journalism, and she is a member of the great sorority, Alpha, Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. She is also a member of the National Association of Black Journalists, and for the last 9 years has been working in Cleveland for WJW TV News, Fox 8, where she is the noon anchor and the reporter for the evening newscast. Alongside these accolades and accomplishments, Ms. Jordan still believes in pouring into the young people of this city and is excited to pour into our 2021 Collinwood graduates. So without further ado, please put your hands together to welcome Ms. Jordan.
Good evening, everyone. Congratulations, Collinwood High School class of 2021. It is my honor to speak here and share this milestone with you. It took a lot of hard work to get here, and you deserve this moment. But this day would not be possible without the love and support of the people around you. Let's also take this time to reflect on how you got here. Your parents, your grandparents, your caregivers, the people who sacrificed for you, who helped you with your homework, who cheered for you at games, who encouraged you in all your extracurricular activities. Let's thank them now with a big round of applause. As we all know, time moves so fast. When you graduated from kindergarten, get this, Beyonce and Jay-Z were on the radio. This was a year when we were all listening to Rihanna, Akon, and Flo Rida. Now, Rihanna is in the makeup business, and there are new artists on the radio, of course. You guys listen to J. Cole, Lil Baby, Doja Cat, Lil Nas X? Okay. Well, your kindergarten graduation probably feels like a long time ago. You might not even remember it. I don't blame you. 12 years is a long, long time, but it's gone in the blink of an eye. One day you're in kindergarten and everyone is listening to Single Ladies, and then all of a sudden you are here. Doja Cat is on the radio, and you're graduating from high school. My daughter recently graduated from high school, so I know how this day must feel for you and your family. I still remember her getting fitted for her gown, taking senior pictures, prom night at the Cleveland Museum of Modern Art. I hear you all had a great time at the Good Time three the other night. Your pictures are beautiful. Every one of these little moments is so important. Each one is an opportunity to look back and think about how much you've learned and grown since kindergarten. Today, though, graduation day is even more important because today you are sharing that sense of growth and accomplishment with your loved ones and with your community. On my daughter's graduation night, all of our family and friends came to town to be part of her big day, and that togetherness is what will keep that day fresh in our minds for many years to come. I'm sure you are experiencing the same thing right now. Life moves fast, and now that you're all adults, it will start moving even faster. Take this day to appreciate yourselves and what you've accomplished. It's a big moment, class of 2021. Today, you enter the next stage of your lives. Whether you're going to college or trade school or starting a new job, you are moving forward. It's an exciting time, and there will be opportunities ahead. Watch out for them. Opportunity doesn't hang around. When it's gone, you can't get it back. All you can do is wait for the next one. I'm here today because of the opportunities that I took and the people who supported my dreams. I always knew I wanted to be a journalist. When I was a little girl, I made announcements into a hairbrush. Dinner will be served in 10 minutes. My father watched 60 Minutes every Sunday and the news every night, so I always knew what was going on in the world. I went to college and HBCU, Johnson C. Smith University, for journalism. And while I was there, I interned at every single news station in the city of Charlotte. When I graduated, I moved to the Midwest, working at TV stations in Kentucky, Indiana, and then back home to New York, where I worked as a reporter and anchor for several different networks. In 2012, I joined Fox 8 here in Cleveland as the noon anchor and evening reporter. I'm now the weekend evening news anchor at the station. But as a reporter, every day brings something new and interesting. My most memorable moment on live television just so happened to be the night I was anchoring the news during Game 7 of the 2016 NBA Finals between Golden State and our Cleveland Cavaliers. Imagine having to deliver the news while on a small monitor right outside the camera frame, LeBron, Kyrie, and my favorite, JR, were winning in grand fashion. My co-anchor and I could not contain our excitement. This was a game that was tied at 89 points for over 2 minutes before Kyrie scored a three-pointer with 53 seconds left. With 10 seconds to go, LeBron made one free throw to secure a four-point lead, and of course, the rest is history. It was such an unforgettable time, and we weren't afraid to share our excitement with our live audience. This is just one example of why I love what I do, and why it's still so incredible to be part of Cleveland television news history. I hope you all will find a career that is just as rewarding. Maybe you already know exactly what you want to do for the rest of your life. And maybe that's the path you're on right now. Or maybe it isn't. But as long as you're honest with yourself, if you can tell what your strengths are and what kind of work is most satisfying to you, you will find the right path. Today is only the beginning. What's next for you is not predetermined by who you are today or who you were in the past. Your life is not the job that you are starting or the school you will be attending. Your life is the decisions that you make every day, They are mostly small decisions, but as the years pass, they will add up. There will be moments like this one today when you can pause and reflect on how far you've come. And if you treat every day as a new opportunity, you will always be able to look back and feel proud of what you've accomplished. 2020 was a tough year. Many of us lost friends and family. Many lost their jobs, businesses closed, and only some of them reopened. We all lost a little bit of what made daily life normal. In forcing us to give up things that we once took for granted, the pandemic showed us what we can and cannot live without. It brought fault lines and divisions in stark relief. It showed us what in life is truly essential. I'm sure you didn't have the senior year that you thought you would. You didn't share an actual physical classroom for even a single school day. We're lucky that we have technology to keep our lives moving forward while we stay safely at home. We can connect with each other even when we're physically apart. You can finish your senior year without entering a single classroom. And you did it, class of 2021. It wasn't easy, but you completed high school during a global pandemic in unprecedented times when nobody had a playbook on what to do. You should be very proud of what you all accomplished. Even if it wasn't the senior year that you hoped for, I hope that you will take this as an opportunity. Not every graduating class had the chance to enter the next stage of life during a global pandemic. You have a perspective unlike anyone else because the year that you became an adult was unlike any that came before. Every high school graduate is at a point of change. Your life will be different tomorrow than it was yesterday. The unique thing is that the world is changing as well, even as we speak. Nothing will ever be the same as it was before March 2020. Where there is change, there is an opportunity to set the tone and the direction of the change. You have the fresh and new perspective that only young people can have. You have lived through a time and an experience that nobody else has before. The world is changing and it is open to new voices. Let it be your voice. You have a valuable one, class of 2021. I became a journalist in order to tell stories. But journalists aren't the only ones, only people who tell stories. Actors tell stories, writers tell stories, even bankers and business people and politicians tell stories. As a journalist, though, the stories that I tell are all true. And to tell a true story, you need to have some curiosity about real life. You can't just make up the details, like a writer or an actor might. You need to ask questions and find out exactly what happened. And once you've done that, you need to tell the story in a way that maintains its truth. I hope that you, class of 2021, have a sense of curiosity about what is true. Don't let the last year slip by. It wasn't a great year, of course, and many people would probably like to forget that it ever happened at all. But you were here and you lived it, and it changed your life and everyone else's. Times of change bring opportunity, and the opportunity can be yours if you grab onto it. 12 years from now, you might not remember what music you listened to last summer or what you learned in math class, but you should do your best to remember what happened in 2020, when the world closed down and you finished high school without stepping into a classroom. This is part of your story now. It's up to you to take the lessons you learned into the next stage of your life. The world is changing, and it's up to you to give it a push in the right direction. I believe in you, and I know you can. Again, congratulations to the class of 2021.
And one moment to our keynote speaker. We have a special presentation to you.
Thank you, Emily.
Thank you very much. Now, as we move on through our program, I want to thank our student speakers for their brevity, because they have moved us right on along. So now we are going to turn this over to our one and only guidance counselor. She and I have worked together now in graduating with this class, 9 classes from Collinwood High School. We have worked diligently to get them to where they are. And without further ado, I present to you our guidance counselor, Mrs. Cassandra Treadwell Motley.
Good evening, everyone, parents, family, class of 2021. Hey, y'all did it? All right. I am here today to present several awards and recognition honors for a couple of our graduating seniors. The first one is to recognize our salutatorian. She has maintained a 3.9 GPA throughout her 4 years at Collinwood. She has participated in a variety of extracurricular activities in school, out of school. She's also challenged herself by taking honors courses since her 9th grade year, AP English Literature, AP English Language, and her senior year, AP Statistics. She also participated in the varsity volleyball. She has been accepted to the University of Akron, Ohio University, Cuyahoga Community College. She will be attending Cuyahoga Community College and major in interior design. Ms. Cheyenne Hamilton, can you come to the stage, please? On behalf of the faculty and staff at Collinwood High School, I would like to present you this small token of our support in your future endeavors. Moving on to our valedictorian, this student has maintained a 4.2 GPA, cumulative GPA, throughout his 4 years at Collinwood High School. He has participated in a variety of extracurricular activities in school and in the community, including the ACE Mentoring Program, Student Council, Student Advisory Board, BG Bros, and he's been accepted to Wooster College, the University of Akron, Case Western Reserve University, Bowling Green, and he will be attending The Ohio State University in the fall, majoring in civil engineering. Nathaniel Duncan, can you come to the stage, please? Present you with your honor cord. And on behalf of the staff at Collinwood High School, we would like to present a small token in support of your future endeavors. Congratulations. I have one more award to present. Each year, a graduating senior from Collinwood High School is selected to receive the Alton Lemoore Railroader Pride Scholarship. The recipient of this scholarship must be nominated by Collinwood staff and possess all 7 of Collinwood's character traits. Grit. Grit is a passion and perseverance for very long-term goals. Sticking with your future day in, day out, not just for the week, not just for the month, but for the years, and working really hard to make that future a reality. Resilience. The ability to withstand adversity and bounce back and grow despite life's downturns. Curiosity, having a strong desire to learn or know something, those who are curious may also actively seek challenges and new experiences to broaden their horizons. Social intelligence, our natural inborn fascination with the world that makes us want to explore, learn, and discover all we can about it. Gratitude, an essential feeling of appreciation of what we have been given. Gratitude is essential to a positive outlook in life. Self-control, the ability to regulate one's feelings and impulses, to recognize feelings and manage them, edit them, and not be run by them. And finally, optimism, the ability to see the positive opportunity in situations. This year's recipient of the Alton Lemoore Railroader Pride Scholarship has been accepted to Ohio University, Cleveland State University, Miami University, and will be attending Wright State University in the fall. Please assist me in congratulating our Debrielle Wilson, AKA Gabby. Gabby is the recipient of the Alton Lemoore Railroader Pride $2,000 scholarship. And also please accept this token from the staff in appreciation to assist your endeavors. Thank you. Oh, here you have it. There you go. Congratulations. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Apologies. I was back there grabbing those gifts, and because we knew they couldn't keep them because they weren't going to walk off the stage with them, we had to take them back. But rest assured, moms, dads, grandmas, aunts, uncles, cousins, those are their gifts. The faculty and staff lovingly put together those gifts, and I was happy to go use their money to purchase them. But at this time, it's my turn to go ahead and say a few words. My name is Falana Williams, and I am their class advisor. And so first off, I just want to say good evening. I want to say hello. I want to say welcome to commencement. Take a load off, because momentarily, you're going to get to the good part. It won't be long. You know, the part you came to see. Not me. I know some of you might have came to see me, but not me. These people back here. The people you really came to see. The people that you have sweated over. You have bled over. You have cried over. You have had sleepless nights over. The ones you applaud and the ones you are so proud of today, those people, that's about to happen momentarily. These young people behind me are about to walk across the stage and officially become high school graduates. I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you to our CEO, Mr. Eric S. Gordon. I thank you and I commend you because this year during this pandemic, he was able to come through with so much money for our babies so that we can make some things happen for them right in the nick of time. So again, sir, I salute you and I thank you. I would like to thank Dr. Lisa Thomas, who will be coming to the stage to help certify your graduating seniors momentarily. She comes to almost every graduation and I appreciate you for that, Dr. Thomas. Thank you to my soror, Ms. Jennifer Jordan, for coming in the nick of time and giving out that great speech to our seniors that are about to graduate this school. To our principal, Mary Miller, thank you so much for putting up with me. I really appreciate it, and I appreciate everything you do, because every time I come to her, I want something for your babies. And she gladly gives it to me. I'd like to also shout out Brandon Towns, our assistant principal, Cassandra Treadwell, the Mark Taubby, who is behind the scenes, and he's at every graduation making sure the stuff happens. Terrence Corson, who you will have heard his voice earlier, and you will hear it as he says the graduates' names. Marcella Hall. Our secretary, Latasha Mason, who definitely works through getting everything paid for these kids. To Monica Williams and Miss May, they held it down at the front doors, and Regina Williams as well. And to my other soror, Candace Dancy, thank you so much for being on the stage and working with our scholars. And to Adam Drow and so many others for all that you have done to help our students and to help me get them to this point. And I want to give a special shout out, she's not here today, to my daughter, Peyton Marie, because I run her around the city of Cleveland getting stuff for your kids, and she does not complain. So I want to shout her out, she's 10, but I thank her for not complaining. Now before I move this program on, I just have a few thoughts I want to share with you about the class of 2021. When I was thinking about what I wanted to say to you this year, I was immediately overwhelmed by all of the things that the seniors missed out on. Literally, I was overwhelmed by that thought. The fact that they couldn't be in person in class, or they couldn't have fundraisers. We didn't raise one plum nickel. The fact that they couldn't go on class trips, the fact that they didn't have a traditional prom and other events that we've normally had, and the fact that we even could not fill this auditorium to capacity because of that thing we shall not mention. But then I realized that we are able to accomplish quite a lot. Our senior class, there's some survivors. Give a round of applause for the survivors behind me. They have survived a global pandemic. And you know they survived because they're sitting on this stage. They have survived being fully remote for the bulk of their school year. No other class survived that. They survived the constant Zoom and team meetings. They survived being at home with their own families. And y'all know how troubling that can be. They survived in a space that no other class has had to endure. And the fact that they are here on this stage today and that you can see their names in the program means they survived high school. No matter what the future may hold for each of these young people behind me, and I call them young people, and I never thought I would do that because they used to call me a young person when I was in Upper Bound some long time ago. But now I done started acting old, and I'm calling them young people. So these young people behind me, please remember that you are brilliant. You are capable, and you are about to receive a piece of paper today that millions, did y'all hear that word? Millions of people have never received. Take a moment and think about that. See, I'm a firm believer. You ain't got to go to higher education. I did. And all the educators that are here, we did. And all the wonderful people sitting over here to my right, they did. But you don't have to be a success. This is the money bag right here. Today, when you get this, this opens up the floodgates. So I am beyond proud of the class of 2021. You have all survived and secured your seats at Collinwood High School's 138th commencement exercises. And I want to do a congratulations to a few people that have dedicated themselves to this class. They came in the nick of time, and that is our class officers. We have a small gift for them. So I'd like to call the class officers to the stage. Our president, Mr. Tabaris Scott. Our vice president, Mr. Vellante L. Paul. Our secretary, Ms. Cheyenne C. Hamilton. Our treasurer, Ms. Charity A. M. LeSueur. And our sergeant at arms, Mr. John L. L. Lewis. Thank you for taking on a leadership role in these very troubling times. I appreciate you. I'm sorry you didn't have the year that you wanted to have, but greatness awaits you. Congratulations to the officers and to the whole class of 2021. So now it's time for me to bring to the stage our board member, Dr. Lisa Thomas, and our CEO, Dr. Eric Gordon, in conjunction with our principal, Mrs. Mary Miller.
Good evening. CEO Gordon, network leaders, including Aaron Frew, Miss Miller, members of the faculty, class advisors, do you attest to the fact that these students here assembled have satisfactorily completed the requisite course of study prescribed by the Cleveland Metropolitan School District Board of Education and the Ohio Department of Education?
I certify that all students on this stage today have met all of the educational requirements of the state of Ohio and the Cleveland Metropolitan School District and have passed all of the required parts of the Ohio State test. These students are now ready to receive their diploma.
Now, by the authority of the Board of Education of the Cleveland Metropolitan School District, I have the high honor to bestow upon you, the members of the 2021 graduating class of Collinwood High School, your high school diploma, along with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Congratulations.
Good evening. It is my pleasure to present to you the graduating class of Collinwood High School of 2021. Nathaniel Noah Duncan. Cheyenne Hamilton. Tabaris Scott, aka TJ. Charity LeSure. Deja Liddell, aka Daddy. Paige Lachelle Willis. Jasmine Woods. Dariana Howard, aka P Money. Valante Paul, aka the Dooney Man. Janelle Lewis. Angel Dozier. Shania Destiny Kimbra. Debria Wilson, aka Gabby the Great. Kevin Lamont Carter, a.k.a. KJ. Trinity Garner Parks, a.k.a. Trin. Triasia Liana Monet Krim. Tavon Brown Robinson. Jamil Wright. Diamond Johnson. Denijah Jewel Cummings. Imantiaja Salima Hinton. Anthony Charles Dixon. Pamela Gould. Jemiah Lynn Alexander. Jamil Mount. Summer Santia Leanne Belcher. Eric Edwards Jr. Anaya Paschel. I present to you the Collinwood graduating class of 2021.
Usually they don't do it anymore after. All right. On behalf of the Board of Education of the Cleveland Metropolitan School District, Mayor Frank Jackson and Chief Executive Officer Eric S. Gordon, I wish to congratulate the men and women of the Collinwood High School class of 2021, their parents especially, and all the families gathered here together. Again, congratulations, everyone.
Good evening, and again, welcome to the 138th commencement ceremony with the one and only class of 2021. At this time, the Collinwood team and I would like to take this opportunity to say thank you to all the parents, students, community members, and educators for your ongoing support and patience during the COVID-19 pandemic, as well as remote and hybrid learning that took place for our scholars. The class of 2021, the world has changed. You are all key players in the second generation to embrace new responsibility, a responsibility to rebuild yourselves and your community. I hope you are proud of this moment and the many more milestones to come. We have missed all of our normal activities this school year. However, we have shared some great moments during our 4 years of high school at Collinwood. The class of 2021, keep on going. Challenge yourselves. What is your barometer of success, class of 2021? It is up to you, the chosen class, for such a time as this. You are a class united, a pandemic class that has the entire world graduating with you. Congratulations, now the hard work begins. And remember, once a railroader, thank you.
Our program is almost through. We have a few things with our seniors. And first coming to the stage again, earlier he wasn't supposed to be here, is none other than our class of 2021 vice president with a few senior reflections, Mr. Vellante L. Paul.
How everybody doing? So we're gonna talk about us as seniors. I wanted to put some words out. I got a couple friends, they didn't graduate at all. I watched them smoke and drink themselves away. So I just wanna congratulate all of y'all, cause we made it. We done. I wanna touch bases on just the coronavirus as a whole, man. I actually almost dropped out. I know a couple of my peoples did, because it was hard. I don't think people understand how hard it was for us. For athletes, you know, people that did volleyball, soccer, we couldn't do none of that. We had to sit at home behind a computer. Mind you, if I'm at home, I'm probably gonna play the game on my phone. I'm not doing no work. So I'm just happy that we all made it. I wanna thank you, even though we ain't had sports, I still wanna thank you. I wanna thank Ms. Miller, because she's been on my back a lot. I wanna thank my mom for sure, because she's been on my back a lot. And that's all I have to say. We did it, though. We did it, y'all. We done. Oh, one last thing. Y'all remember how we used to be at the lunch table talk about what we gonna do after we graduate? Well, we graduated, so what y'all about to do? Move on, y'all. And I got some gifts from Ms. Miller and Mr. Towns.
And also, we also got a gift for none other than Miss Williams herself. So you come here, girl. Come here. Because you know this for you.
Thank you. I was so angry when I didn't win the Vax-a-Million lottery last night. So this will suffice. Thank you. Better than that. Come on. All right. We have one last thing before we end this evening, and that is our historical passing of the mantle ceremony. This ceremony was skipped last year, unfortunately, because we had a drive-through ceremony. But graciously, we have two young ladies sitting in the audience right now that are about to join us on the stage. I was able to catch two of our class officers from 2020. The other three have moved away and were not able to attend. These young people that are in the audience right now that are about to come up to the stage would have, last year this time, made all of the class officers officers. But without further ado, I'd like to invite our two 2020 officers to the stage, Ms. Dejana Jenkins and Ms. LaShia Bryant. I would also like to call up our class officers from 2021. One second. Let the ceremony commence. It is my pleasure to present to you our outgoing officers from last year, President Ms. Dejana Jenkins and Secretary Ms. LaShia Bryant, and presenting the 2021, their outgoing and their incoming officers, so they're going and coming, Mr. John L. L. Lewis, Sergeant at Arms. Miss Charity A.M. LaShore, Treasurer. Miss Cheyenne C. Hamilton, Secretary. Mr. Vellante L. Paul, Vice President. And Mr. Tabaris A. Scott, President. Congratulations, Railroaders. You may be seated. Now I'm going to urge our newly graduated seniors, I'm sorry, y'all not seniors, our newly graduated alumni, I urge you to pull out the alma mater just in case you don't know the words, because we're going to say this, and then we're going to get on up out of here. To all of the new alumni at Collinwood High School, congratulations. Please rise. And to all of our guests in the audience, please remain in your seats as our class, our newly graduated students will be recessing up the aisles to receive their actual diploma and gifts that the staff and Cleveland Metropolitan School District has bestowed upon them. So give them a few minutes once they recess out, and they'll be ready for you for all the pictures and loving you're trying to give them. And now for our alma mater. O Collinwood, thy praises now we sing. Dear Collinwood, to thee our gifts we bring. We hail thy colors, both the blue and gray. Thy spirit leads us on our upper way. And as we come to take our leave of thee, pledge our love, our faith, and loyalty. Thy sons and daughters free, go forth to love and serve humanity. The lessons thou hast taught in hall and field shall be to us a bulwark and a shield. And if the years shall bear us far from thee, we'll hold thy name, hallowed memory. Congratulations again. So you guys know you're leaving, right? Y'all know y'all graduated. And y'all know after we give you that diploma and those gifts, you ain't never, ever, ever got to listen to me again? All right, so act like you know. Y'all ready? Okay. We're ready with the music.